My name is David Berger, and all around the world these days everybody says that earthquakes can't be predicted accurately, and I'm going to run a bunch of videos and show you that the world is not telling you the truth. Earthquakes can be scientifically detected well in advance from precursors, and let's get started on how to do it. We'll go one video at a time. This video here is actually going to be about quartz and limestone. Basically what I do is I use a seismic system that uses piezoseismology. That's just a name that I made up myself, because when the materials in the earth or anyplace else comes under pressure, it gives off different charges. And if you happen to have like quartz or sand in most areas, and you're driving over top in your car, and all of a sudden when you have this unit, the chart will be something like this right here. As time goes in this direction across the chart, and this is the amount of force that I'm showing in this particular case, three different seismic units. And these two over here will be in different places, while this one here is just a common seismic unit. So a car drives by, there's no car here, and then all of a sudden the car drives by, and all of a sudden the seismic goes off, and the car is gone, and then the seismic goes to normal. That's a regular seismic system. But if you're using a piezo seismic system and the car happens to be driving over a quartz bed of like sand or something like that, or granite, then as the car starts coming towards it, it creates pressure on the ground, and as the car drives over top of the ground, it creates a positive signal. And in this case, your seismic signal will go up, and it'll start coming across like this, and it'll take a long time for it to come down, and then gradually it'll be back to where it was. But if you're driving it, a car in a different area, or a truck or something like that, and you're going over like limestone, instead of your system going up like this, your seismic system will be coming down like this. It comes down in a negative and then goes across. So as your car comes towards you, it starts coming down, and time is going this way. It shows the car here, and then all of a sudden it comes back up and then goes across. So what you're doing is you're starting at datum points on your seismic system, on the piezo seismic system in particular. And as time goes this way, it'll either go up or it'll go down. And usually if you're out there detecting earthquakes ahead of time with the precursor signals that come from earthquakes, and all earthquakes have it no matter what the magnitude is, as long as the depth is within reason, you know, not 800 kilometers or something like that, because that's way out of range. But if it's like within the normal 2 to 20 miles in depth, then it's detectable. So what happens is down in the earth, the another earthquake usually happens someplace else, and then when that earthquake hits at the distance, let's say I'm here in Kansas over by Wichita, Kansas right now, and let's say one hits over New Madrid, an earthquake hits over there, a specific earthquake, not every earthquake, but just this specific earthquake, let's say, happens, and it detects, the seismic system detects it hitting over there. And when it does, it creates pressure here in this area all of a sudden. Before, it was normal ground pressure. The radiation in this area was just normal. And then all of a sudden, after that specific earthquake hits over there in New Madrid, then the pressure here increases and goes above normal, and it's suddenly detectable. You're in the precursor stages of an earthquake. And here in the Wichita, Kansas area, if the precursor signal starts off, and it's like everywhere in the world, it's the same, that each earthquake has a precursor cycles of about 15 minutes the first day, 30 minutes the second day, 45 minutes the third day, and the fourth day is 30 minutes, it goes back down, and then 15 minutes. That's a 5-day cycle. Earthquakes have a 5-day cycle on them. So that specific earthquake over there created the pressure here. So then you jot down exactly what time it created the pressure here in the state of Kansas, and then you start watching the signal. And so basically on the first day you'll expect some kind of signal where it'll you'll see the pressure will be on for like 15 minutes solid, you know, it'll be approximately 15 minutes the first day, and then it'll jump to a specific amount of pressure timing, which will be, let's say, somewhere between 4 and 10 minutes. Usually it's between 4 and 7 minutes, and usually it's around 6 or 7 minutes is where they usually are. But they're somewhere in that range of 4 to 10 minutes, it'll hold the pressure. So when you're out there, let's let's get this thing going here real quick, like. And you're watching the pressure. The first day is 15 minutes. That's the first day. Second day, it'll be 30 minutes. The third day, it'll be 45 minutes. The fourth day, pressure signals will be 30 minutes apart. And the fifth day, it'll be back down to 15 minutes. Now this is a cycle. And this cycle is the precursor cycle before an earthquake can strike. But this doesn't mean that an earthquake has to strike at the end of the cycle. The cycle can start over and the pressure can be released anywhere along this time. We'll talk about when to figure out when an earthquake's gonna strike a specific area later. We'll talk about that later in another video. But right now, we'll talk about that specific earthquake over there that happened like over New Madrid. Let's say it happened over New Madrid, Missouri. And over here in Wichita, Kansas, all of a sudden the pressure started being detected over here. So on the first day, you'd watch it, and they'd be 15 minutes apart. And then in this one here will say that they lasted for 7 minutes on the precursors. So every 15 minutes, the pressure would be something like this on your seismic system. Your piezo seismic system would come over here, and then it would go up. For 15 minutes, it would be coming across like this. It would be down here to regular. And then all of a sudden, the pressure would be up here, and then it would hold for 7 minutes. We're just saying this. This is an example. And then it would come back down, and then for 15 minutes, it would hold, and then for 7 minutes, it would hold the pressure back here, and then it would drop back down, and then 15 minutes, and then 7 minutes. It would do this all day long, basically. There'd be a little exchange towards nighttime and stuff like that. But during the daytime, when you're watching the cycle, it's like 15, 7, 15, 7. This is for specific.